Addressing health care for women at every stage of our lives. That is the goal of the Wisconsin Alliance for Women's Health. But just what are and where are the greatest needs? Sarah Finger, director of the Alliance, joins us this morning. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
You had your first ever policy summit last week. First of all, what was the turnout? Explain what happened that day.
We had over 300 individuals come to Madison last week. Including healthcare providers, survivors, advocates, individual everyday women that wanted to come and help figure out ways to raise the status of women's health in Wisconsin. So unprecedented turnout and a wonderful day filled with networking and idea sharing.
Why did you do this? I mean, where did you see that there was a need for this, and where do you hope it will go from here?
Women have unique healthcare needs, and when it comes to women's health policy, there's a lot of competition right now for advocacy initiatives and funding dollars. And we want to make sure that women's health policy is a priority in our next legislative and budget session. So we really wanted to come together and understand how we, as a collective women's health community, could unite and together raise the status of women's health.
Some of the most important discussions that happened that day, what were they?
We covered all sorts of issues. We know that there are a lot of issues that affect women's health, anything from mental health, violence against women, reproductive, maternal child health care, cancer, chronic disease.
Those, I listed some
right,
of the ones that you had
right.
said.
So we know that there's a diverse list of issues that we need to consider when we come together and propose women's health policy initiatives. And so we really took a look at all these individual issues, but then looked at how collectively they intersect and how we, again, as a women's health community, can collaborate and come together and introduce policy initiatives that address all those issues.
Anything that stood out for you that day? Any personal stories?
Oh, there were incredible stories that came out. Survivors of heart disease, survivors of sexual assault, survivors of cancers. We had a whole panel on individual women telling their stories, how through a healthcare challenge they found their voice in the advocacy arena and have really found a way to advocate for themselves and for other women. So very powerful day, and you know, a lot of it comes down to getting the proper funding for the kind of programs that work to help raise the status of women's health. So we have our work cut out for us next year.
I was going to say, yes. Where do you go from here with that?
We go now from, this is a really important first step in the process. We have collected some initial recommendations over the summer. We'll be really hashing out a comprehensive women's health policy agenda, which we'll look to introduce to the public in September, just in time for candidate interviews and candidate forums, where we can really put our priorities in front of those looking to seek public office and who will be in a decision-making position next year.
Most important thing you want our viewers to take away from, I mean, what is the Wisconsin Alliance for Women's Health?
We're Wisconsin's women's health policy leader, and we're really here to monitor state and federal policy that affects access to health care and information for women in Wisconsin. And
so, you want to get involved?
You can go to supportwomenshealth.org, and we encourage anyone who's interested to get involved as we, again, raise the status of women's health.
All right, we've got a link to your website on our web channel, NBC15.com. Sarah, great to have you in this morning.
Thank you very much.
We'll talk to you soon. Still ahead this morning at 11, we've got some more of the day's headlines.